And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity. Blind. We're gonna talk to Palagina. Speaking of, who's making noise over there. Whenever we bring that new player on, we find there's a whole bunch of things we have to say to them. Been so long since I played this. Hold on a second. No, that's not what I want.
I understand. Yeah? Tell me.
Oh, this is horrible. I forgot. Okay.
Que?
Yeah, okay.
Need something?
Palagina's eyes glimmer with a divine spark as she coolly appraises you. I forgot, you know, I haven't been playing this game. I've been waiting for my headset to come back, and then I, you know, was trying to get caught up with the other game I'm playing, and fell behind in this one. Let's just go in order, I guess. I was wondering about your order, the Brotherhood of the Five Suns. Palagina nods softly. Back in the Republics, we called it the Firmas Mezcanxolias. The Five Sons are the Duke's Bells, the great dukes who rule over the most powerful republics, Sparento, Ascensi, Salona, Ozia, and Revua. The Duke's Bells keep the republics moving forward, keep us at the forefront of trade and technology, keep us strong against our rivals. We brothers are sworn to aid and protect them for the good of the republics and their citizens. How does that work? With five dukes, they can't agree all the time. She throws her head back and laughs. Ha ha ha, of course not. They argue endlessly in the Sangreta Ducala. The Brotherhood is forbidden to take sides in their debates. Not that I'd want to. I'd rather risk life and limb fighting the Republic's enemies than listen to the droning lectures of the Ducal Congress. Our loyalty is not to individual dukes, but to the dukes as a whole, to their collective will and resolutions. We follow the mandates of the Ducal Congress. The individual dukes direct us, but they have an understanding of how we are not to be used. I want to ask you something else about the Brotherhood. Palagina nods sharply. When did you become a brother? I joined the Order when I was very young, only 6. I did not pass my final examinations until I was 20. It's not something I ever expected to happen. Pirates attacked the town where my family lived. It was not uncommon when I was young. They were more of a nuisance than a real threat, but they were persistent enough that the Duke of Ozia saw fit to send the Fremas to deal with the threat. I was enamored with the idea of being one of them. I didn't even know what it meant to serve a country then. I didn't really even know what the republics were. I was just a little girl, but maybe I wanted to be them because I saw how people celebrated them. I saw how people thanked them for what they did. Most of all, I saw how they left. Left this place that felt like a prison to me. So how did you wind up joining? My father resented me and my presence. When he learned that the Brotherhood accepted my kind, because we are not considered women, he asked if I could be traded in exchange for taxes he owed on his land. The recruiter believed that having a godlike among the ranks would be prestigious, so he accepted in spite of my physical limitations. Why did your father resent you? Because I was born different, but more than that, because the birth hurt my mother. It left her unable to bear more children. She weakly shrugs her shoulders. It's why my father traded me to the Brotherhood. My mother, she was a different sort, kinder, more forgiving. She did not blame me for being what I was, but when my father looked at me, he saw his family line ended. He hated me for it. That's strange. Our lives are strange. There are other ways my father could have dealt with me. He could have killed me at birth. No one in that village would have thought less of him. She shrugs, the membranes of her eyes sliding out and back from beneath her eyelids. Being sold to the Brotherhood turned out to be the better alternative. Let's talk about something else. The membranes of Palagina's golden eyes slide out and back as she softly nods. I want to ask something else here. What's so great about the Valian Republics? Long ago, the Grand Empire of Valia thrived. As the Empire collapsed into the warring states of Old Valia, much of that old culture was lost. The Old Valians see grandeur in the acts of their forebears and believe it elevates them. They are a tired people from a fading time. There was once beauty in the great cities of the Empire, but there are few alive today who ever saw it. The Valian Republics are a rebirth of Grand Valian culture, but we are more than just that. While Old Valia was content to look ever backward, the Republics will shape the future. You say brothers, but... But my breastplate bulges in the wrong spot? She cracks a small grin. I may look like a woman and sound like a woman, but according to the Republic's laws, I'm not. What they call godlike, people like me, we can never bear children, so we can't be real women, for what that's worth. Most people in Republics, if they can't bear children, it's like the sun has set on their lives. But what it was worth to me, freedom. The Brotherhood has a prohibition against women entering, but I was allowed. Many resented the decision, but I learned long ago not to care. How do people in the Valian Republics feel about the godlike? Like with anyone who's different, most people are curious or afraid, and if they're afraid, she shrugs, they get angry. They want to make sense of the world, and people like me can be confusing. And believe me, people are easily confused. Her tone becomes more serious as her voice and gaze drift off. After a long moment, she looks back to you. We all have to protect ourselves, no matter where we are. Being different means always looking over your shoulder, no matter what company you keep. Well, this is a stupid question now, as she's told us all this. You're one of the godlike, aren't you? Haha, that's what they call me, yes. I've never met a god, so I don't know what they're like. I can't say why everyone presumes to understand why I was born this way. Where in the Valian Republics are you from? I was born in a fishing village near Biagap. Her brow furrows, her golden eyes looking away as she searches for a lost memory. Can't remember the name. She waves her feathered hand dismissively. I was only there for a few years. My best memory was leaving the place. Like all the other brothers, I grew up under the Ozean bastions. It wasn't easy, but I prefer it to gutting fish. Why are you concerned about Animancy and Defiance Bay? People look at the Republics as a nation of traders. We do engage in much commercial trade through Defiance Bay, but the greatest value we have found is not written on a ledger line. It's intellectual wealth, the ideas that we exchange. The Deerwood and the Valian Republics are the world's leaders in Animancy. If the Deerwood institutes prohibitions against research and practice of animancy, it will have serious repercussions for the Valian Republics. Do you see animancy as just something to be traded? She snorts dismissively. I'm not a scientist, but I believe animancy can benefit us all. There are so many questions to be answered about who we are, why I am the way I am. If we can answer them, maybe we can make life better for everyone. Don't you think there are dangers in animancy? Of course it's dangerous, but we who live in the Eastern Reach, we are the children of pioneers. We sought out the danger. She nods her head decisively. This is why all of the best research must happen in the New World. I'd like to know your opinion on something. She nods her feathered head sharply. Ask and you will know. How do you think things are going? I'm glad you know how much can be gained from diplomacy. In the Brotherhood, we are trained to keep our physical strength in reserve and use wits and words to navigate our way through most conflicts. She raises a feathered finger to emphasize her point. There will always be a time for war, but I am glad to see you have the restraint not to succumb to the desire every time the opportunity arises. You've spent a lot of time in the Deerwood. What do you make of it? It's not the Republic's, but the Deerwood is one of our closest allies. We trade more with the Deerwood than any other nation, and we have no greater ally in supporting animancy research. Palagina shakes her head slightly. Still, I do not understand the Deerwooden obsession with revenge and feuds, nor the widespread hatred of Orlans. The Orlans from Ir Glanfath fight for their homes and their culture, as anyone would. They fight dirty, but I would too if all my enemies were twice my size. Do the Republics view the Aedir Empire as a threat? We used to view the Empire as a threat. Since the revolution in Deerwood, the Republics have benefited from the shield that the Deerwood provides. It's another reason why I fear the fall of Defiance Bay. If the Deerwood is weak, Aedir will surely test the Republic's dominance in the Eastern Reach. What do you know of Ra'atai? They've done impressive things with cannon and artillery, and some of their ship designs are interesting, but they shout too loudly over minor accomplishments. She smiles softly, waiting for Canna to pipe in. No one seriously questions that the Republics control all sea lanes in the Eastern Reach. I'm disappointed that she didn't voice any of that. Alright, let's head back to Andra's gift.
Sure.
All of us. Alright. You know what? I'm gonna break here. I'm gonna go rest up. Because we're back to this lighthouse next. So, see you on the other side. Okay, here we are.
Laying low.
Okay. Now. Our wizard.
How may I help? My shop.
This is gonna make us in the dark, but alright, that's better. Okay. We'll try to make it so that people that these things can't spawn around him.
Yes?
Eh?
The Adess will go on this side of him.
Hmm?
Durance.
Hi.
On this side.
Hmm?
Following your lead. Right away.
Canna right in front.
Hey.
Hey, dear.
All right, then.
Right in front.
Quay?
Quay? And then, Palagina. We'll draw them out.
Tell me.
I'm just gonna save the game here, because we may very well die. I'm stuck there for a second.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, run back. I don't even want to erect a shield yet because I want Palagina to be around at the Holy Radiance thing. Let's see if this will work, because I'm just going to do a minor missile on this shade and have her run back. I don't want anyone to move. I'm afraid if we're not in range that she'll start moving forward. I don't want anyone to move. So let's just do this. Alright. Endurance. Hit us with Holy Radiance. What can you do? Lay on hands. Oh, that's good. Flames of Devotion. Field triage. Okay, Flames of Devotion. We'll do that. I'm not sure what's going on here. Can't deselect that? Oh, here we go. I was clicking on her. Spectre. How about this shade? Dominate. See if we can get one on our side. As far as the rest, let them come closer. And now they're closer. Oh, Thetis had to run away. That's not good. One minor missile on there. What do we got here? Bonus to defenses sounds good. Circle of Protection. I don't think knockdowns work, but... Ah, see? It's hitting him. Where's... Theodas. She interrupted. Interrupted. Can is here, okay. Well, interrupted, let's... Amplified thrust off of a dare. Mm-hmm. Fireball. Cool. We are attacking this one, correct? No, he's attacking. Well, he's engaged with this one, but I still keep hitting this one. Palagina, hit that one. Dare hit that one. If you guys hear beeping, it's my fan controller. And it really shouldn't be going off. It's not that high. I don't understand. Anyway. Who else we got? I was a little distracted now. Alright, we've got rid of one. One just popped over here. Shocking. No. Soul shock off of Adair. How about a restore minor? On most of us. Is this Theodas? Help out on the Spectre here. We got rid of that thing? Okay, cool. Apparently. I think. Another fireball. I want to make sure we don't target any of our friends. That's interesting, it won't even let me get any closer. I guess it needs space with which to fly. He's hitting Aloth. Restore minor. Oh, oh. Cool. Okay, now I can go. Restore minor. Including Canada this time. Another fireball. Oh, now we can get closer. Canna's running now. I hope he doesn't get hit. Ah! we doing? These guys still have plenty of hit points. So who's this? Adair? Still trying to kill this specter. I don't know if these guys are connected here. He's connected to him.
What?
Oh, wow. Restore light. Where's Canna? That's Canna. Okay. Restore light here. Is Canna being hurt so bad that it's not working on him? Or did it not? Or is he getting interrupted? Because I think he got interrupted. Again. Okay, he's just getting hit a lot, I guess. The Spectre's almost out. I don't think that would work on undead. And I don't think the Chronic Lance would work either on undead. Hit this Spectre. Oh my god! Moderate. Right here. I don't think he can be healed, can he? Trying here. This is Aeloth. Or is he totally incapacitated now? He's got 9 hit points, it says, out of 66. Oh, now he's got 5. Okay. Palagina. How about lay on hands? Forgot about that. Do amplified thrust off of Adair again. She's got enough focus back. Okay. He's still got a spell in progress. Might as well just. He's out. Every time he tries to cast something, it stops him. Does that mean he's completely dead? Okay, one more down. Who's where? Durance, Palagina. She got hit again. Minor. Another one appeared. Where'd that come from? Running out of healing spells. Now they're hitting. This one's almost dead. How many? Just two? Hold on a second, guys. Okay, that fan controller is pissing me off. It should not be going off, and I don't have time to mess with it. How about everyone just pile on this shadow? Are we done? Nope, there's one more. Everyone on this one. Oh my god. That was highly annoying. Now, I don't suppose we can sleep here.
Got it.
Try to stick together. All right. That was step one. I'll be back with step two. Then I defeated these things. Hopefully they won't respawn in this area and we can continue on. And I hate when that happens because our characters are all the way over here.
Your own father sold you to the Brotherhood?
He hated me anyway. I was glad to be gone. The Dukes are my parents now. The Republics, my children.
That's an interesting way of looking at it.
Yes. Okay. Off screen, we will go back and heal up, and we will be back to the lighthouse next episode. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.